All right, we are back with a brand new car to the Hoogies Imports fleet. This one just landed in from, it originated from Ashikaga, Japan. We're just right outside of Tokyo. That's where it spent its whole life. We just got it a couple weeks ago. This is a 1997 Daihatsu Rocky. Super cool little 4x4. Apparently these make great off-roaders. I have not given a shot yet, but I would definitely like to in the short period I'll be owning this vehicle for. But as you can see, this is the Canterbury of New Zealand edition, which I'm not really sure what that entails other than these cool zebra stickers, which are in fantastic condition, along with the rest of the vehicle. The paint's really nice. Could use a nice little buff or polish to just shine it up back a little bit, but no fade on it or anything like that. Really nice. Just rolling on the factory 15-inch wheels with auto locking hubs up front. It's really nice. Tires are in great condition. This thing appears to have been really well taken care of. But yeah, cool feature on these ones is that this top roof panel here and this rear panel right here are removable. So you can go full convertible on it if you'd like, which is really fun. I've only driven it once without the top because it's a little bit difficult to take the roof off by yourself, but it's definitely doable. But anyways, the Daihatsu Rocky, we did have it in the States for a few years, a very short run in the States. We had it from sometime in the late 80s to 1992, so we would have never had this 1997 model here. So the only difference is it has the same drivetrain and everything like that, but it just has a minor facelift and everything compared to the ones that we had in the States. This one, of course, has a nice bull bar, some nice factory options, some nice side steps there, some cool fog lights up front. Super 4x4, nice. Canterbury of New Zealand edition, very cool. But yeah, like I said, no rust whatsoever on this thing. Spent its time right outside of Tokyo, inland Japan. Not too much snow to worry about. No salty coastal air to worry about. Let's come over and I'll give you a quick look underneath. Show you it's super clean. Of course, I'll get some better pictures eventually. Yeah, look at those stickers. Super cool stickers. I love it. Totally 90s. I love that so much. So cool. Nice factory rain guards. Rocky. Very nice. All right, let's take a look at the interior. Again, super clean. Only 30,000 miles on this thing, so very minimal wear. So you can see just slight wear on the bolster right here, which, you know, that's the part of the seat that takes the most abuse over time. Some floor mats that the previous owner put in there to protect the integrity of the carpet underneath, which has done a great job. The carpets look fantastic under there. Let's take another look. Perfect. Super clean. Of course, it needs a little bit of a vacuum. I have not done any of that yet. Little foam pad. Don't know what that was used for. Previous owner, you never know. You never know what you're going to get exactly when you order stuff from overseas, but super happy with the condition of this thing. But as you can see, we got everything. Got the factory clock, level gauge, and battery gauge. Let's take a look. See, 48,950 miles, which is just over 30,000 miles. Yep, tachometer, speedometer, all you need. Very nice, really nice seats. Love the cloth. We got the factory granny seat covers, which you'll get every now and then from a car from Japan. I just love the look of that. Got the rear seat back there. Not too much to talk about. Decent leg room. Not the most comfortable thing to sit in, but you know, if you scoot up a little bit, it's just fine. Sun visors, of course, very nice. Factory AC, factory power windows in this thing, power locks as well. Once you lock the door, And of course this one is a five speed manual, shifts perfectly, like just like butter, you know. Synchros are perfect, transfer case super smooth, super easy to use. Let's see, rear window lock. And yeah, I apologize for the state of cleanliness. I have not given this thing any kind of wipe down or anything as of yet, but I will, of course. Let's see here. Aftermarket radio, I believe. Yep, I believe that's an aftermarket radio. And here, we'll give it a cold start real quick. Let's check that out. Starts up perfectly every time. Haven't had any kind of issues. Perfect startup. And again, another little factory, or another little floor mat. Some aftermarket radio antenna wires that come back through here. And there was something mounted here at some point. I don't know exactly what it was, but yeah, we have that little, looks like some kind of antenna connection. Not really sure. You don't really know exactly what what kind of stuff the previous owner may have done in here, but no issues. So yeah, this little roof panel, it actually opens up, or you know, just lifts up slightly if you would like to, and you can actually remove it altogether if you'd like to do that as well. But to do so, just push these two side buttons there, open that up, and then we get a little extra airflow. You won't need too much. The AC does blow nice and cold, so can't complain about that. But you know, with the roof setup and everything, it is fantastic. I won't be taking the roof off in this video, but I will put a photo of the vehicle without the roof on at the end of it. And I'll go around to the back right now, actually. Let's come on around the back. Daihatsu Rocky. Over here. So yeah, here's the trunk space. Sorry again, I apologize for the dirty seat. I have not wiped it down at all, but you know, just some loose dirt on there that can be wiped off. So yeah, there's the trunk space. You know, not the most amount of space, but it is a very small vehicle to begin with. But you can fold this seat down and then pull this lever to fold it all the way up. And of course you get a lot more room back there. Very cool little feature. This is not an aftermarket foam pad or anything like that. This is just some foam pad to protect the carpet that the previous owner put in. As you can see, it's done this job well. The carpet's super clean. Yeah, and we have the factory roll bar that goes up and around along the roof line, which is cool. Yep. And then this whole section, of course, the rear roof removes. Just some bolts up there. You can see we have all the factory covers on there. One of them, that one's cracked, and that was my fault actually, because I took the roof off, and I believe that I was the first one to ever do so in this thing. I don't think that the roof had ever been removed, so all of the bolts were on super tight, and these plastic little screw covers were very brittle. I feel bad about being the first one to take it off, but that's what it's made for. I just had to see what it looks like without it, and I had to take it first spin without the roof on there. But yeah, as you can see, the roof liner is really clean. Let's see, what else is there? To remove the roof, yeah, of course, you remove all of those bolts. All of those bolts there. So it is not the easiest thing ever to do. So you'll definitely want to make it worth your while. If you're going for a nice Sunday cruise or something like that, then it'd be perfect. Front seats again, nice cockpit. Let's see. Yeah, so you remove the roof, take out all those bolts, and then you're better off having two people lift it off, because one person, it's not very heavy, but it is very bulky. So just, you know, make sure you have two people together to do that. Yeah, once you remove all those, you can lift it out. Super easy to lift off. Oh yeah, these windows also, they open up. Let me show you that real quick. Right there. You can see, very nice. Got the roof open there. super cool. It's always cool to see the versatility of some of these vehicles. Anyways, once you remove the roof, then you want to come back here, remove the glass panel, which you just actually just undo four bolts. One, two, three, four. And then you have to disconnect the rear defrost, or the rear window heater. Just the wires, you know, super easy to undo. Just pull them down and then put it back on when you're done. But yeah, that's that. But yes, I have seen around the internet to be extra careful with this window piece, because they are basically a unicorn at this point. They're very hard to find. So if you ever do, if you are the new owner of this vehicle, be very careful taking that thing off. Put it in a, store it in a safe, very safe place when you go full convertible in this thing. But anyways, that is the interior, and I will be right back with the engine. All right, so we're back in the engine bay here. It's the engine that powers this 1997 Daihatsu Rocky. It is a 1.6 liter straight four cylinder, pushes out right around 100 horsepower, I believe. It goes straight to the rear wheels through the 5-speed manual transmission. And of course we have the four-wheel drive high-low transfer case if you ever want to go four-wheel drive, take it off-road. Yeah, super clean, as you can see, no leaks or anything like that. Only 30,000 miles on this bad boy, so it is good to go for a long time. Idles perfectly smooth, rev smooth. You know, it's not the most power in the world, but it's definitely enough to get you going. So yeah, there it is. But same engine that we had in the Daihatsu Rockies over here in the States for a short period. So the essential items like timing belts and things like that, timing belts, accessory belts, super easy to get. So yeah, there's really no problem there. I know these are popular in a lot of different countries around the world, so parts are easily accessible on websites like eBay and you know, other sites like that. So yeah, it runs and drives great, no issues there. I'll keep the hood up, actually. Let's come around. Actually, here, we'll do it from this side. Give it some revs real quick. Revs beautifully, no problems there. Come in here, give it some revs. It's perfect. Transmission also is perfect. Shifts into all gears like butter. Synchros are perfect. No complaints there whatsoever. Only 30,000 miles on this thing. I mean, it feels like a brand new car. Yep, and then we also got the four-wheel drive high-low transfer case. Again, shifts into the different four-wheel drive. It shifts into four-wheel drive at high and low like butter again, you know, just come over here, straight down for four high, and straight, and then over to the side and back up for four low. All engages perfectly. I've tried it all out, and then that's it. Back into two high right there. Let's see, what else is there to talk about? Let's see here. Got some little cool little documents from its previous owner, I guess, in Japan. Just some interesting documents. Say, I don't know how to read kanji, but I use my Google Translate app, so I guess this guy was born in the 40s and did some kind of radio tower work across Japan. Obviously, he didn't travel too far in this thing, but I think that's why we see some of the old radio accessory stuff in this vehicle, such as this wire here that runs back to this old mount, and there's like a antenna hook up there or something like that. Then we can come around to the front, and it looks like there was some kind of mount for an antenna or something like that on here. I mean, I'm not exactly sure what that is, but you never really know about the past life of these vehicles. But I believe that's what it was, and I think that this is the same wire that goes back and through to the back seat where he had some kind of receiver hooked up back there. But it's all taken out now, and just that's what remains of it. And then there must have been something on here as well, but you never know for sure what you're gonna get with these cars from Japan. But overall, this thing is in immaculate condition. You know, there are some little scuffs here and there, but nothing too crazy for a 25-year-old vehicle. But only 30,000 miles on this thing. It is the lowest mileage vehicle I've had so far. And AC works, blows nice and cold, kicks right in. Ashtray, I don't believe it's ever been used. Doesn't look like it's been used. They have these little balls that could have been used, who knows, but the cigarette lighter looks really clean. Doesn't look like it's ever been used for a cigarette. So that's the AC. The radio works, of course, but we only get the Japanese frequencies on this thing. So if you want to, you probably have to, if you want to get the radio stations over here, you'd have to change it out for something a little bit newer that receives the US frequencies, of course. That's the same with any Japanese vehicle that you import. But yeah, I guess that'll pretty much do it for this walk around. So if anyone has any questions or anything like that, just, you know, leave a comment down below, and I will hopefully have a good driving video for you guys pretty soon. Thanks, guys.